Hi guys, welcome to another video, and in this video I'll walk you through how you can create a chatbot, an AI chatbot, using your custom knowledge base. So the first question is that why do we need to build a chatbot when we already have ChatGPT, Googlebot and Llama? So the thing is that we'll be training this chatbot with our custom research and custom data. So the data or research which you have not open source yet, or it's not yet available in the data of these open source large language model, so you can use this video to create a basic AI chatbot which will help you create a basic level chatbot with your own custom data. And we'll be using OpenAI API Key and Llama index to create index and context of our data, and we'll be giving that context to our chatbot, where we'll be able to interact with our data. Now you should be thinking that we can give this context directly via ChatGPT in the chat interface. That's not going to work, because if you have a large chunk of data, you won't be able to give it in one single prompt or even in multiple prompts. So what we're going to do, we'll create the data and create index of the data to feed in for our custom chatbot which we are creating. It's a pretty basic tutorial. We'll be using Google Collaboratory in order to create our custom knowledge base AI chatbot. So if you're interested to learn it, keep watching this video and don't forget to subscribe the channel. I am trying to increase my AI knowledge and trying to create more videos related to AI, artificial intelligence and stuff like that. So without further ado, let's get into the screen.
Okay guys, so first thing first, you will find the Google Collaboratory link in the YouTube video description. Once you click on that, you will have a screen like this where you can see all the different commands and instructions. And now the second step is to create an OpenAI API key. Again, creating a custom chatbot will cost you a little bit, because there are we'll be giving API calls to ChatGPT, and we'll be using ChatGPT 3.5 model. Okay. Now go to platform.openai.com, and from there you will be able to generate a new API key by going to API keys and then click on create new secret key. Okay, you can check out the pricing here. So if we click on pricing, here we have the pricing of different models. Like for ChatGPT 4, we have 0.06 for 1000 tokens. And the script which we are using will cost you around 3 cents or 4 cents maximum, but it depends on data. So I'm currently using my website data. So I just copied the data from the homepage and few other pages and created a GitHub repository, just like you can see that on my screen. So there's a GitHub repository where in the data folder, I have added the TXT files with the data of my website. And there's another TXT folder. There it is. So these are the two text documents which I added in my GitHub repository. And if you go to Google Collaboratory, that's the GitHub repo link, which will copy the data in this environment of Google Collaboratory. So once you open this Google Collaboratory, click on connect here. You should be seeing a connect button here. And once you click on that, it will be connected. And here we go. It is connected. Now I'm gonna click on this play button here. Now what it's doing is that it's cloning the data from my GitHub repository and downloading it to this Google Collaboratory. Okay, the command has been completed. Now if I click on refresh, you can see the data is uploaded here. Within the data folder, there are two TXT files. Again, you can use your own custom data. If you don't want to use GitHub repository, you can simply upload the folder from here. So there's a upload button here. You can simply upload the folder, and within the subfolder of data, you can upload your data in TXT format. And if you do that, make sure to update that here. So when we will use Llama index and create index of our data, that's where the data is grabbing it from. So it's pulling the data from custom chatbot slash data, which is custom chatbot, this folder, and the data. Okay, Now, after running this command and downloading the data from GitHub repositories, just click on play on this second, under settings, second heading, and where we are just installing the dependencies of Llama index and lang chain. Again, I'm also a student of this because you guys might have seen a lot of Shopify tutorials. I have basically started with WordPress and then learned Shopify, and thankfully to you guys, I'm getting a lot of good response in terms of comments, views. I'm also getting a lot of inquiries and customers to build the Shopify stores and etc. But I am trying to increase my learning to these new AI tools, and hopefully I'll be able to help you guys with my journey. Okay, these dependencies are now installed. Now scroll down and we'll click on play button here. Okay, it just took 2 seconds. And then on the third step, you will need to replace your API key from here. Currently, I'm using this API key. Don't worry, I'll delete this key because if you guys use the same key, my credit card will be boomed. So I'm going to delete this key, but you will need to use your own API key. And for that, you need to go to platform.openai.com and create an account. Add your credit card from billing section, credit card in billing and payment methods. So you'll have to add a card and then click on create new secret key and then name your secret key. Let me create a new one, chatbot, new tutorial, create secret key. And then all you have to do is just copy this and paste it here. And click on play button here, and that's it. And now fourth step is to create the index. So it will create a JSON file which will be readable to large language model. The large language model will be able to understand what is the data which is being added on top of the, basically we are fine tuning the large language model with the additional data which we are providing. Okay, now click on play button. And once you do that, you will have index showing up here. And let's refresh on our folder section. And here we go, index.json file has been created. Now if I double click, you can see the indexes are created. So these are all of the indexes for the data which we provided, which is under custom chatbot data. And if I check the data here, you can see I just basically copy and pasted my website, content, and just pasted within the TXT file. Okay. And if I check the second file, similarly, we have some data here. So in this file, what I did, I just click on view source and then copied the whole source and added in this file, which is like in the services page. Okay. Let's close it down. And we have completed the fourth step. Now in the fifth step, we will run our chatbot and let's hit play button to see how it works. Okay, our chatbot is running. Now, as you can see, I have given some sample questions. Again, you can use your own questions. And who is WebSense Pro? And as you can see, our chatbot read the data within the TXT files and given the response back. The response which we have here is not possible to be generated via ChatGPT or Bard because they don't have that in their data model. So we can simply add in a lot more data in shape of TXT or PDF files and then create a chatbot and then ask questions from this chatbot. What are the services provided? Let me ask another question. Okay, so it's basically read the data which I provided, and as you can see the second TXT file, I just copied the whole source and added that in TXT file, but it read the data and given back the response, which is actually really cool. I personally love that. So in upcoming videos, my goal is to create a complete user-friendly chatbot, web-based chatbot, where you guys will be able to install that on your website as well. So that's it for the tutorial, guys, and basically these videos are for my own learning. So if you are learning from my videos, feel free to let me in the comment below, and we can work more in our learning in shape of new AI tools. Okay, until next video, have a great day.